Okay. I give $4.
Actually, this sigma is a perfect conductor. Then this value is infinity. It's infinity conductivity. Then for instance, the polymer, not polymer, free space, then free space, this sigma should be close to zero, right? Okay, close to zero. So conductivity, this is very important, also five-star important parameter, okay? Is a measure of how easily electron can travel through the material under the influence of externally applied electric field. Okay? So, sometimes we need to use this quite often, so I will read this here. The parameter each one know, and you know, right? Okay, so in the previous chapter, the intrinsic impedance, also, the C is equal to 1.1 then is 3 × 10⁸, right? Okay. Those constant values. Anyway, we will give the first page in our exam paper, right? So. Then we apply the Ampere's law. Ampere's law. Okay? So for Ampere's law, this is conduction current density. This is displacement current density. Okay? If sigma in free space, sigma is zero, right? Okay, now it's lossy substrate. So in the previous chapter, in the chapter one, right, of the second half, this sigma is equal to zero, right? Now not equal to zero, then what will happen? Okay, what will happen? Okay, then we group this together, then we have this, actually, in the last chapter is equal to J omega C into E. Now is epsilon C. Okay? So in chapter one is epsilon. Okay? Right? Now this in this chapter this is a complex permittivity. Okay? Right? So in the previous chapter is just the real number. Real number. Okay? So this will bring the difference. This will bring the difference. So now the imaginary part has been introduced, right? Okay? For lossy medium. For lossy medium. Okay? So we have the imaginary part. This is the real part, imaginary part for lossy subject. Right? Okay. Another five-star important concept is loss tangent. The ratio of imaginary part of real part is called the loss tangent. This is the imaginary divided by real part. Notice this epsilon actually is equal to epsilon r times epsilon log. Okay? Right? Okay. Here, when I guess let down in our calculation, you may notice. Okay? Here, this I point out here for this. This epsilon here is equal to epsilon r, right? Okay? Now, for lossy subject, we can use similar approach, so then the complex relative permeability is equal to epsilon c divided by epsilon naught, right? So the real part is still the same, then the imaginary part, the epsilon r, 2 pi, right? Okay? Then become this. As mentioned, conduction of current density, this is expressed in the current density. Also notice, since J is here, then conduction current and the displacement current are out of phase by pi over 2 because of the J, right? Okay? This is the real part and the imaginary part, actually, phase difference is pi over 2. Okay, this very important parameter, this also very important. Okay? Then by introducing the this complex propagation constant, then the Helmholtz equation can be simplified, actually similar to previous one in lossless substrate, right? In lossless substrate. In lossless is K, now it's Kc, right? Okay? So the difference is, now the difference is epsilon c, okay? So in lossless is epsilon, right? Epsilon. Now it's replaced by a compact number. Turns out this k also is a complex number. It's a complex number, okay? So another, later I will mention another challenge, how to do the square root of a complex number. If you bring your calculator, you can check whether you can do the complex number, the square root of a complex number. For instance, the j, right? Square root of j, what is the result of square root of j? Right? This is a challenge. Okay, let me explain how to do the complex number, how to do the square root of a complex number. Okay. Then, how to denote the complex propagation constant k? So this jkc actually can be represented by alpha plus j beta. Beta is similar to those the propagation constant in chapter 1. Okay? Now the alpha, actually alpha is attenuation constant. Also notice the unit is so-called network per meter. Okay. Now this alpha is attenuation constant, means the magnitude will attenuate with location with height, okay, right? Will decay. alpha greater than zero, beta also greater than zero. Okay, then the solution for the Helmholtz equation, the solution. Previously, this is a propagation in the positive direction, right? The solution in the positive direction, right? Okay. In the lossless, now K is replaced by Kc, right? Okay, what is Kc, right? JKc, okay? Now, is this can be divided into two parts. One is E minus alpha z. Another, this is the same as before. This is the same as before. This is the difference of the solution, right? This is a difference. This is a difference, right? Okay, since alpha is greater than zero, right? So with different location, with the traveling, then this magnitude will decay, right? Okay? It will reduce. This is similar for those values, those relationship in the first chapter, right? The only difference is K now replaced by Kc, right? Okay?
Yeah, okay.
Then propagation, then those relationship also similar to previously, right? Similar to those case in the first chapter. Okay, now the big difference. Okay, here the big difference is this complex intrinsic impedance. Okay, so in the free space, what is this value? In free space, is lossless, is 120 pi or 377, right? Okay, is a real number. Now, in lossy subject, this is a complex number, okay? Why it is a complex number? Because this one is a complex number. Okay? So for complex number, then a phase will be introduced. Right? Bear in mind, this is a big difference. Okay? Big difference. Okay? Later we will explain this. Then for this E and H, electric field, magnetic field, so this is the same, now the difference is here. Okay? Now for magnetic field, this just now mentioned, this is the phase in complex intrinsic impedance, right? Complex intrinsic impedance. This is the difference. You should be careful about the difference, right? So alpha is a attenuation constant, magnitude decay by this number of travel distance. lossless medium special case, alpha equal to zero, right? Alpha equal to zero, theta is equal to zero. Right, theta, okay. Because this here for this case, theta A is equal to zero for lossless, right? This is a difference. Then this is very important chart as mentioned. Okay, right? So this is the x direction, y direction, z direction, right? Now, electric field still in the x direction, magnetic field in y direction. So E is perpendicular to H. The K, this is K, right? K direction. K is perpendicular to D, perpendicular to H, right? Okay? K is the power propagation direction, right? Power propagation direction. Okay? Now notice this because this is a lossy subject, now the maximum value will change, right? Maximum value will change. Okay? Right? This is lossy subject. Okay, for lossy subject, basically we will only look at two special cases. Okay, two special cases. One is good conductor. Good conductor. We will only look at two special cases. Another is low loss dielectric material, okay? Low loss dielectric material. So how to distinguish the material is a good conductor or is a low loss dielectric material? This is related to our daily life, right? A good conductor or low loss dielectric material. For instance, we use the foundry house, like the silver silicon substrate, right? Okay. The wave propagate in the seawater, the wireless communication in free space, in seawater, okay? Then we will characterize all this subject. Okay? How to distinguish? Actually, we use this parameter. The sigma of omega, this epsilon, also from here, you may notice this omega is here, then this will be related to operation frequency. Means this criteria could change with frequency. Okay? Now let's look at some example, okay? First, let's look at the good conductor. Good conductor. So, for wave propagation, for wave propagation in the lossy subject, the first thing we need to do is to determine this. Calculate the ratio, whether it's much greater than 1 or much less than 1, okay? But different scenario, different equation should be used, okay? Should be used. Now, loss tangent, if this is much greater than 1, for instance, 100, then the steps, just for your information, okay? The conclusion, later I will highlight those conclusions. Anyway, I will explain this procedure, okay? This procedure, the KC, okay? The complex propagation constant is equal to this, is equal to this, right? Actually, K is omega. Sorry, right? Okay. Now, it's a complex number. This is a complex number. So it's 1 over 2, right? Okay. So since this value is much greater than 1, so we can drop this one, right?
We can drop this one.
When we do this square root, okay? Now, anyway, we need to do this, how to do square root of j, complex number j. So, have you brought your calculator? Yes? Can you calculate the square root of J? Right. What is the value? Square root of J.
On the bottom.
Can you go? Square root of J. Get the answer? Square root of J. Square root complex number, right? Okay, who can give me the answer? Have you learned this before?
No.
What happened? How to do this? Then some student ever given the final exam ever asked my calculator. That's a problem, right? Okay, cannot do this. Okay, so since, yes, the normal calculator cannot do this, right? This right, okay? Then you have to convert this. What is the J? Is equal to the J value. Is equal to EJ90°, right? Okay. Then EJ90°, then square root of J is EJ90 over 2, right? Then it's EJ45°. Then EJ45°. Is 1 over square root of 2, 1 plus J, right? Okay, then bear in mind, for complex number calculation, you first you need to convert for explanation form, then you can do the square root, right? Okay, then for minus J is E minus J. 90°, right? There is E minus J, 45°, is 1 minus J, square root of 2. Okay? Right? Okay? So, turns out, then we have this value. Since omega is 2 pi f, then divide by 2 is pi f, mu sigma. Okay? Mu sigma. So, J can see, right? This is. So, J can see is equal to. We always use times J. Because J can see, this is characterized by the alpha plus J beta. Okay, this is a attenuation constant. This is similar to what we have learned in the previous chapter. Okay, so now turns out the attenuation constant is equal to beta, equal to square root of this value. This is a very important conclusion. This Feinstein important parameter. Okay, for good conductor, the attenuation and from getting constant, right? Okay. Also notice here is J times complex propagation constant. Okay? So then from there, the velocity also notice we always examine the velocity and the wavelength, right? When wave propagate in certain medium, right? Now the phase velocity is omega over beta. What is beta? Beta is this value, then we can have this. The wavelength 2 pi over beta. Beta is this value, you can obtain this. So phase velocity, wavelength, now you can calculate, right? In a good conductor, so another very important parameter we need to calculate is intrinsic impedance. Intrinsic impedance, okay, is complex number. Complex number. Okay, so this is the definition of intrinsic impedance, previously in Ezra, now replaced by complex permittivity, right? What is this? It can be replaced by this complex number, right? Okay. Now, since for this good conductor, this value is much larger, greater than 1. So 1 can be dropped, right? Can be dropped. Okay, then turns out is now we still have the J, right? Square root of J. So since you have understood how to do this complex number calculation, right? So it's 1 plus j divided by 2, right? Okay, turns out mu omega, this will be cancelled, right? Will be cancelled. Then just now 1 plus j divided by square root of 2, right? Then 2 times sigma, okay? Right? So also this omega just now is one student mentioned this is W. Okay, this is omega. Okay? Omega is equal to 2 pi f. Okay? This not W is omega. Okay? It's 2 pi f, then divided by 2. Okay? You have pi f mu divided by this. Then turns out here, actually, mu pi f, this in the previous page we have derived. This is equal to alpha attenuation constant, right? Attenuation constant. Okay. So then the bottom is sigma. Now turns out this is equal to this. Okay. Then for this value can be represented by this. This goes are very important. So in the previous